Students, welcome to this e-learning session. In this session, we are going to learn types of chemical reactions. Students, the chemical reactions are classified into the following types of reactions in accordance with nature and the number of reactants and the products. They are combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double displacement reaction. Examples of combination reaction. Take some hydrochloric acid in a flask, heat it and hold a glass rod which is dipped in ammonia solution near the mouth of the flask. What you observe is white colored smoke emanating from the tip of the glass rod. In second example, magnesium wire is burnt. What you observe is white powder of magnesium oxide is formed. If you take calcium oxide and add it to a flask containing water, what you get is calcium hydroxide along with generation of large amount of heat. You can see the bubbles over here which indicate that large amount of heat is produced. In all the three reactions, what you have observed, two reactants come together to form single product. So, when two or more reactants combine in a reaction to form a single product, it is called as combination reaction. Now, the decomposition reaction. Take some sugar in an evaporating dish and heat it with the help of burner. What you observe is black colored substance is left in the evaporating dish and the water vapor leaves the evaporating dish. In second experiment, when calcium carbonate is heated strongly, carbon dioxide gas is formed which turns lime water milky and calcium oxide is left in the test tube. Students, you have seen electrolysis of water where on passing electric current through acidulated water, oxygen and hydrogen gas is collected in the test tubes. Thus, here you will observe that from one sub-reactant, we get two or more products. So, the chemical reaction in which two or more products are formed from a single reactant, then it is called as decomposition reaction. This is third type of reaction, displacement reaction. The reaction in which the place of the ion of less reactive element, over here copper, is taken by another more reactive element, over here zinc, by formation of its own ions. You can see zinc has changed to Zn plus 2 ions. Then it is called as displacement reaction. Example, take copper sulfate solution in two beakers and in second beaker add a zinc plate. What you observe, after some time the color changes from blue to colorless. Why it is so? Because the zinc from the zinc plate changes to zinc plus ions, Zn plus 2 ions, and it displaces Cu plus 2, that is copper ion, from copper sulfate, and what is formed is ZnSO4, that is zinc sulfate, and that is why the color becomes colorless. Two more examples are given over here where to the copper sulfate solution we add iron, that is Fe, we get FeSO4 plus Cu, and we add lead, that is Pb, to CuSO4 solution, and what we get is PbSO4, that is lead sulfate and copper. A question must have arisen in your mind, why zinc, lead and iron displace copper from copper sulfate. The answer is reactivity series, which you are going to learn in the lesson metallurgy also. Here if you will find copper, it is to the lower side where unreactive metals are there, while the top metals are highly reactive, so zinc, iron and lead are to the reactive side of the reactivity series, and that is why they can displace copper from copper sulfate solution. Now the fourth type, that is double displacement reaction. Let us find two examples where silver nitrate solution is added to NaCl, that is sodium chloride solution. What we get is sodium nitrate plus white precipitate of AgCl, that is silver chloride. You can see the downward arrow indicating precipitate. This is white colored precipitate of silver chloride. In second example, we add potassium chromate, yellow colored potassium chromate solution to barium sulfate solution. What we get is potassium sulfate plus barium chromate. You can see the yellow colored precipitate of barium chromate. Now here you can see the ions have exchanged. Ag was earlier with NO3, now it is with Cl. So AgNO3 has changed to AgCl and NaCl has changed to NaNO3. So exchange of ions has taken place. So what is double displacement reaction? The reaction in which ions in the reactants are exchanged to form a precipitate is called as double displacement reaction.